I think number four is interesting because we have something invisible here. If I keep thinking about this is AX plus BY equals C, what's in place of the A on this one? There's a one there, isn't there? So I can make it visible if I want when I'm doing the work. I don't have to, but for some of us, it really makes it make more sense when you can see the number instead of just knowing it's there. What am I going to subtract here? I'm going to take the x away from both sides. And remember, it's a negative 1x that I'm taking away. So I end up with negative 3y equals negative 1x plus 6. What does our step 2 ask us to do? Divide everything by B. What's in place of the B in this equation? Negative 3. I'm going to rewrite it over here. Negative 3 over negative 3y leaves us with just y. Negative 1 over negative 3 becomes 1 over 3x. Minus 2. Where did I get the minus 2? Positive 6 divided by negative 3. Okay, I didn't think we'd have time to get to the graphing today, but we will be prepared to do some of that tomorrow. And then we will also look to method 2 and show you another way to graph from standard form that might make problems like this easier to work with. Okay, so you can tuck all of these things into your notebooks.